How's it going, everyone? Coming at you with an early morning coffee rip. And what we got today was a little PSA submission that we sent in about a month ago. We're going to check out our grades and see if we're starting the day on a good note or a bad note. So let's get into this. This was a, let's say, 12 or 13 card submission, economy submission. Got drawn for the $50 economy. So majority of them were my cards. I had one from Scotty, three from Grant. So we're going to get into this and hope we did all right. Some mid to high tier cards in here. Nothing got upcharged or anything like that. So we assumed correctly on value. It was anything up to $1,000, give or take a little bit. They're pretty lenient on some of that stuff. There were some of these cards I felt had some minor defects, but we're gonna hope for the best. Some of these I even kind of regretted right away once I sent them, but I don't know. The hype of it all, you get that submission, you get a little excited, you want to start sending some stuff in. So sip coffee there. Let's go. I was excited to get these on Friday, but the wifey was up the hill hanging out with the neighbors, and my delivery person wouldn't deliver it without a signature. So here we are, Monday morning. I think I said Sunday morning, but it's Monday morning. I had to drive up to the post office and get them. So, all right, let's start off. First one was a Tyrese Maxey. This is a red cracked prism. 9. Okay. I knew one of the corners was a tiny bit soft on that. Hoping for a 10 still. But 9. Starting off not on the greatest note. I tried to send them in to kind of set it up. I sent my worst cards that I felt in the very, very beginning of the sub. It'll kind of set them up for grading the next ones a little bit better. Hopefully. That's what you want to think. But next one was an Anthony Edwards. This was an orange reactive prism. 8. Oh, okay. Not starting off great at all. Don't know what the issues were with this one. Maybe there was some surface stuff that I didn't see. But an 8. Oof. All right. So far, not off to a great start. Luckily, these aren't the bigger cards here. Kaprizov, Young Gun. These are almost impossible to gem just because of corner issues on upper deck cards. So I was hoping for a 9 on this one. We got a 9. All right. So happy about that one right there. Jude Bellingham. This one was to 150. This was let's say like neon green and yellow. This one looked really good. I was hoping for a 10 on this one. 9. Oh, we are not doing great. Corners were perfect. I mean, you can't really do centering on these cards. So I don't know where they dinged me. Maybe the softest tiny bit of corner up there. I don't know. But a 9. Ugh. All right. Justin Herbert. This was an Emerald Parallel for Mosaic? No, Illusions. Illusions Emerald Parallel. That one got a 10. All right, now we got some 10s. All right. Got off the old Schneid. So, Emerald Parallel, PSA 10. So happy about that one right there. This is one of my bigger cards. This is a Juan Soto Rookie to 99. Silver Border Archives Rookie. So I thought this one, just because the silver border and it's a paper stock, that it was not going to gem, but hoping for a 9. 9. All right. Perfect. That's what I was hoping for. I know some of the corners are a little bit soft, and there was a tiny, tiny mark. Where was it? Oh, up here, right in the corner. little black speck. So I thought that might have caused it, but I was hoping for a 9. Got a 9. This one is Grant's. This is an Aaron Rodgers downtown. Looked really nice. Hoping for a 10. 9. So it does look like there's a print line on there. So I'm guessing that is what brought it down. Nice looking card, though. Some hillbilly in Wisconsin will like that. Goddamn Packers. Fernando Tatis image variation with the air. This one looked really clean. Hoping for a 10 on this one. This has the little yellow mark on the bottom, the yellow dash, which gives it the air. And that one got a 9. All right. That's the air right there, the little yellow. That one was also Grant's. This one was mine. This is a Bowen Byram autograph. Red Rainbow Auto. This is one of the ones I kind of regretted sending in. Bowen Byram's got a lot of upside, but especially with the Avalanche going into the playoffs and how well they're doing. You can see a little off center on the back right there. So thinking 9, hoping 10. We got a 10. All right. Makes me a little less regretted of sending that one in. So that one has a lot of upside here coming in the next couple months with the playoffs starting. Byron's been battling a few injuries, but he's a stud on the blue line. This was a Billy Gilmore autograph out of Stadium Club, just a base autograph. Card looked really clean. Auto looked nice. Hoping for a 10 on this one. 9. Okay. 9 on that one. Not sure where they found the issues with on that one. But apparently, oh man, they got a hair underneath there. What the hell? A little hair up in the corner. Not cool. Not cool. So that isn't great. I'll have to reach out to them, see if they will re-slab this, but no idea where the 9 came from. Thought it was a 10, but maybe it's the hair they added to it that brought it down to a 9. All right. One of the bigger ones right here is a Mike Trout auto to 5. This was Scotty's up the hill. Paper stock on these ones, the significant statistics out of Series 2. Hopefully this one got a 9. We were shooting for a 9. We knew one of the corners was a little bit soft. 10. Oh, damn. There we go. That's huge. That's a huge gem right there. Wow. That's awesome. That is awesome. Which makes me wonder how mine are getting 9s. This one where you can see white down there in the corner, but hey, we'll take it. That's awesome. Gem Mint 10 Mike Trout auto to 5. That's a freaking monster card right there. That is sweet. And then we have a thicker card. This one was Grant's last one. This one's a Mike Trout patch auto to 10. This one was out of Update. Patch autos, obviously the bigger cards always make it difficult. Gah, 5. What? Oh, that is brutal. We knew that they had a little bit of crease issue on the corner of the 70, but man, a 5? Damn you, PSA. That is a sick card, though. At least it's now encapsulated. These thicker ones obviously feel a little bit weirder, but damn, 5. That's crazy that that can get a 5, and then I send in these 1960s cards with rounded corners, and they come back 6s. Damn. Well, that is a big letdown on that one. I know Grant will not be happy about that, but not much we can do once it's in the hands of PSA. So whatever they saw that we didn't see. I mean, the edges all look good. Corners look good, which is crazy for these thick cards. So I don't know. Man. Damn, that's not how we wanted to end this one, but it is what it is at this point. So, a couple tens, not a ton. What do we have here? The Bowen. So, Grants. A lot of nines. Unfortunately, some eights. Or 1-8. That one's staying in my PC anyways. I was going to sell it if it gemmed, but we'll just hold on to that one. So we had the Gem Mint 10 on the Herbert, Gem Mint 10 on the Bowen Byram, Gem Mint 10 on the Mike Trout auto to 5. And then nines, I had the Billy Gilmore, Juan Soto, Jude Bellingham, Kirill, will probably stay on my PC, and the Tyrese Maxey. Grant had the nines on the Aaron Rodgers and the Tatis. And obviously the five on the Trout patch auto. It's the final kick in the nuts right there at the end of that submission. So didn't do great. I don't know if we just got a grader on a bad day or what it was, but I'm gonna get these thrown into bags, get them sorted, and hope you enjoyed that video. So I'll be coming at you later this week with a little something else, and I'll start working on my next submission. All right, have a good one.